Hello, my dear students. Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Muhammad Imran Qureshi, again here with you, the subject Market Technology Intelligence. We were here in lecture 7, Introduction to Marketing Research. In lecture 6, we have already studied about the first part of the Introduction to Marketing Technology Intelligence. So this lecture, this is the part 1 of 7th lecture, where we are going to learn 3 major things. The first, we want to understand what is the market information system, management information systems, and how it is linked with the marketing information system, and then decision support system, how organization they use decision support system to make decisions, and how research is important, the role of marketing research in MIS and information system and decision support system, okay, DSS and MISS. So this is the second outcome of today's lecture. The third outcome, we are going to study about the ethical consideration of marketing research and how we have to deal with these ethical consideration during our research process. So these three major outcomes for today's lecture. Okay, let us start with the first marketing first outcome, which is basically differentiation between the marketing research and decision support system. So we have to understand what are these two components and how they work in the organization. Let me tell you one thing. Marketing information system is basically the collection of information, internal or external, in the organization where all these data has been utilized for decision making or decision support system. The first thing, we collect information internally. The internal information that can be billing, your production process, your other records, annual reports, all these, your employee, your HRIS systems, all these systems are basically components of your management information system, which deals with the internal information of the organization. If you remember, I use one word in my class, the organization memory. If you remember, the organization memory is something where we store the data, the information which organizations use for its purposes, that is organization memory. So this organization memory generates the management information system, how information flows between the organization different departments. So this is internal information. At the same time, we also collect information from external sources. For example, we collect information from the customer, we collect information from the client. I hope everybody knows that the difference between these three, client component and consumer. So we collect information from these sources also. This information basically called external information, but not only these three, customers, client or consumer, but there are some other stakeholders also from where we collect this information for the management information system. Okay, this is the second component. The third component, these two components, they develop your marketing information system. This information system is basically the basics of your information which is required to support your decision making process. So that is called decision support system. So information system provides you information, but at the second time or second end, decision support system is a bit different thing where we use some different mechanism to develop or to utilize that information. So let us focus first on marketing information system. So marketing information system is basically the utilization of information which we collect from the market internally or externally, internally within your organization and externally outside the organization. It is basically an organization system where we utilize the information which is flowing into the organization and then we try to use it for our decision making process. So what is this information? The information is basically based on your computers, your organization's hardware and software, and then the users who are using this system. Okay, so this is the main components of your management information system. The same for this marketing information system is basically to collect information internal or external to the market. So this is marketing information system where we try to collect information internally or externally from the market. Okay, so let's see what is marketing information system or management information system. They are two different things, but here as a point of reference, I'm giving you examples of management information system. In the management information system, we try to solve the structured problems because we are using information already available in the organization in the form of your employee feedback or in the form of your customer's feedback. Or the user, they use the system, a management information system. So all this information, you can generate reports, you can see your data in the form of reports, and you can try to use this to solve your structure issues, structured problems. For example, I am planning to enhance 5% of my marketing sales, or maybe production, or maybe the employees. This 5% in next 5 years, it means that I have a structured issue and I have to increase my workforce in next 5 years for 5% more. Similarly, in the other cases, if we are using some marketing information or we are trying to use some enhance our market share of 5% in one next year, so I need to improve my production process. So these all are basically your structure problem, where you already know what is the issue and how you are going to plan for solving that problem. So that is the structure problem. But these structure problem, usually we use reports. These reports can be generated, the same you use for Google Form. You know that we can collect data and then we can utilize that data. Already your information system will give you some readable or presentable information or reports that you can utilize, annual reports and all other descriptive analysis. All these reports are available in your management information system. For example, I want to see one student who have been absent in my past two classes. I want to see what is his track record. Did he attended my classes and he already submit all the assignments? So all these information is available in our management information system, and we can utilize them to see or to solve that particular issue. The third thing, the third component is basically information display is restricted. Remember the third component. What does it mean? It means that the information system will give you some information, not the analysis. You can take some report, maybe the frequency, descriptive analysis, but not very deep analysis is possible with the information system. It just collects the information and give you reports. For example, I gave you example of Google Form, and you also know your ULearn is also an information system, management information system. So you can use that as an example, and you can see these informations are being utilized, but we are restricted to display. Not so much possibilities are there, okay? So information is restricted. But this information is also fair enough to utilize this information in terms of making your decision. So that is possible for some structure problem. You can use this information to resolve your issues, but up to some extent, not all issues are possible to be resolved with this information. So initially, MIS allows you to see your reports, see your employee performance, see your production performance, and generate some basic reports. That is possible with the MIS system. But remember, the components of MIS systems are hardware, software, the users, and the infrastructure your organization have. So these are the components of your MIS system. So I hope MIS system is very clear now. MIS is basically a system in the organization which is used to collect information or store information and to control the flow of information within the organization and outside the organization. But it is basically based on hardware, software, users, and your infrastructure available to your organization. Okay, now this is management information. Obviously it is used for structure problem, but we have limited display of reports, and then we can assist decision management system based on this information. Okay, but those information are already stored in your system. Let us see, maybe we have to go one step ahead. We have to see whether our organization is able to sustain this growth for next 5 years. whether my employees are learning and what would be the learning curve, whether if I change my employees A department to employee A to department B, so what would be the effect. These types of situations or these situations need detailed analysis. These decisions are not possible to take based on only the information which is available in your information system internally. We need external information also. To collect the internal information, for example, I'm planning to develop a new design for my product. So I have three or four different designs in front of me. So how I'm going to decide which one is the best for the market? Yes, internally we decided these four. But how I'm going to improve and how I'm going to utilize one out of these four? Now this is the stage where I have to combine external information. Remember I told you, internal information is your organization information, your employees information, your production process and marketing process. And the external information is basically the information which comes from the external sources. Okay? So decision support system, let's come back to the decision support system. Let's understand, try to understand. I told you the decision support system combines the information, internal information, MIS, and external information in order to support your decision making process. So what is the information system now? Decision support system is an interactive support system, interactive system that allows you to access the information, play with the information and try to use it for the decision making process. So there are some characteristics which we need to understand in order to understand the decision support system. For example, it is interactive process based on your hardware. Obviously you can use computers for that. Obviously you have some devices, mobile devices, and many other devices are already installed on in your even in your institution. You can see these are the hardwares, the hardware part, then the software part, which is we are using different types of the software in order to process our information or analysis of our information need to be done on this software. And then the data, the third important component is data. So we have users, they input the data, or any other mechanism we collect data internally. Yes, organization can collect data from their employees who are the users and maybe their client, but external data you need to collect from market research. Okay, so I'll explain it later how this market research is very important in order to explain to you the role of marketing information system in decision support system. So decision support system is an interactive system which based on your hardware, software, data, and then the fourth component is basically the models. Remember, in management information system you don't have models, you just have reports, and you can utilize them for simple decision making for structured problem. But in decision support systems we are trying to solve, or we are trying to make decisions on the problems which are not structured. Okay, so for that reason we need some models. Models can be statistical model or analytical model. There are many types of different models. The model is a step or a sequence of programs or sequence of activities that we use to solve any problem. So in decision making, obviously you make decision because you are facing any problem, any challenges. For this reason, if you are using decision support system, you need to identify a complete design or complete model. Model is a step of activities or step of sequence of actions that allow you to take decision on any particular situation. Okay, so remember, decision support system is an interactive system which composed of hardware, software, data, and your models. Okay, clear? Let's move to the next point. Now I already completed my first component of today's learning outcome. The first one was basically to differentiate between management information system and decision support system. So management information system is the information system or the information which flows within the organization, and we use it for the structured decision making process where we already know the problem and we try to solve the problem through already available data. But in reality, the problems are not always structured. So if you are facing some difficult problems or the problems which are not structured, so we'll try to utilize decision support system. So decision support system, we already have the mechanism, then we use those mechanism in order to make decisions. So there are few types of decision support system, but there are some basic requirements. If you are trying to establish a decision support system, you need to understand few basic requirements for that. The first thing, it should be interactive. The people, they can include information, they can change the model, or they can try to see whether the different analysis can be done on this data or not. Okay? Then human element should be there. The decision is always need to be done by the human. So you have to keep this part. Not all the decision support system should be based on artificial intelligence. Yes, we are using them a lot, but still the human element is there, because the decision makers are your boss, maybe your supervisor, or you as a manager, you have to take decision, or business owner. So decision making process or decision support system is dependent on the human ability to make decisions or to develop the model that will work in different situations. Okay, so human elements should be there. And importantly, you have to use both internal and external information. We have to use all these information together in order to make any decision. Okay, internal information, I already explained, if you are using any information within the organization and collecting through management information system, yes, it is internal information. You can use them, your production process, employees and all this. External, you can collect through market research and other research processes. Okay, so internal and external, both information need to be combined in this process. Okay, decision support system, they are complex. Unlike management information system, maybe they are not so much complex as compared to decision support system. And final, the main requirement is the models. You have to use different types of model in order to make your process efficient. So what types of models are there available? Okay, so your decision making is based on the ability of a human to make the models for different issues. But nowadays we are using machine learning to make your models more efficient. I'll give you some examples of some models so you can understand how we can use different models. But remember, the most important part is your decision support system will allow any human to make decision easily. So that's why the human interaction, the element should be there, and it supports decision making. This is the last requirement. Let's see what type of models are there. Basically, you can use mathematical or statistical model. They are very easy to use and it will give you correct results. But there are other models also. Scenario analysis is there. You can see or you can try to understand the future scenarios. You can have Delphi methods. All these are different types of modeling approaches which are available in decision support systems. Okay, so let's see one example. The first and most commonly used model is what if analysis. What if you are using any programming language, you would be more clear about this. What if it is a condition. Let's say one variable, one situation, or one construct, or maybe one element of your decision making process. If we change that element, what happens to others in the model? Let's say your model is composed of four or five different elements. You are looking at the salaries, you are looking at the satisfaction, maybe you are looking at the sales, and you are looking at the customer satisfaction. Now these four you develop in one model. You combine them in one model. Employee satisfaction, customer satisfaction, your sales and salary. So what if I just try to see, if I increase salary up to 5%, what would be the effect on other component? Whether my employee satisfaction would be increased, obviously, maybe it is increased. And in that case, he's going to work more harder and try to convince more customers. So customer satisfaction also can be affected with this. So this is called what if analysis. You try to change one variable and try to see the situation which occurs after changing one variable. So this is what if analysis. The second one is goal seeking. This is inverse of what if analysis. So the goal seeking is basically you see how different components they are going to affect one element of your model. You can repeat this situation in same case. Okay, you can try to develop your understanding by utilizing similar example but in inverse cases. Okay, and then sensitivity analysis. We try to figure out the effect of percentage, one variable, what is the effect and how much would be the maximum effect. Let's say if I increase 5% of salary, yes, 10% of motivation is or increase or satisfaction is increased. If I increase 10% or 20% of salary, maybe motivation and satisfaction increase 20%. But if I use 30%, the motivation is still increased 20%. It is not increasing anymore. So this is called sensitivity analysis, where we try to optimize our constructs or our variables in the model. Okay, I'm just giving you very quick examples over here. And then exception reports. In some cases, some of the variables or some of the constructs, they cannot be captured within the data. We try to assess those variables. We try to see how we can utilize information to predict those variables which are not categorized with this. Okay, so that is your exception reporting. These are the different purpose of your or different models of your decision support system. So I hope you are very clear about the decision support system. In decision support system, we use models. In management information system, we just use reports. Okay. Now the second component of our today's learning outcome, which is basically the role of marketing information or marketing research in marketing information system in your decision support system. Okay, so I hope you are very clear about management information systems and the decision support system. So what is the role of marketing research in this MIS and DSS, especially the decision support system? Remember, we need internal and external information. We have to utilize that information in order to get our desired results. We want to predict our sales. We want to predict our future. For this reason, we need information. Internal information, if you are just relying on the internal information, you are not doing well. Even sometime for internal information, you need researchers to investigate whether your employees are satisfied or not, for example. To investigate whether your working environment is good enough. There are many examples of these internal research within the organization. I give you examples of Frederick W. Taylor, who is the founder of scientific management. If you see his research and the history, what he did, he basically, it is called pig iron experiment. What he did, he tried to see whether the employees, if they move, or the labor, if they move in a correct direction, or if we reduce the number of movements per working unit, then their productivity will be increased. So he applied scientific principles on the management of employees, and then he got a very good result. But at the same time, he did research within the organization. So you can do that. The information may be collected through the research within the organization, but at the same time, the external information also required research. That's why whether your customers are satisfied or not, they have been using your product since long. So did you collect the feedback? What is their feedback? Are they okay? They need any changes? Are they satisfied with your services? All these questions are need to be answered, but you are not able to collect this information. For this reason, maybe you need some researcher to do that. So marketing research is a very essential and very important component of your organization. Without this, maybe most of the organization, they are not able to grow, or maybe they are not able to extend their market shares. Okay, so internally or externally, you need market information, and this market information you have to collect through your resources. And maybe in some cases we use internal teams for research, market research, but if we don't have these expertises, you have to hire external body. There are many organizations available for this working, and you can use that. But there is one more component. Nowadays you can use social media to collect all this information. Most of these internal researcher teams, they use social media extensively to collect the information. There are a lot of benefits for the social media. Why? You can utilize your internal human resource and collect data and do your market research based on your social media marketing research programs or tools and techniques. Big data analytics are available. So a lot of information available on social media, and you can utilize those information in order to get your desired information internally or external to the organization. But these strengths of social media, I think we have discussed enough about the social media marketing, and you are doing this activity and also your assignment based on the social media marketing and all this. So you know the power of social media, but at the same time there are some limitations of the social media also. You are not able to do face-to-face interaction during the, so emotions maybe they are missing, face-to-face interaction they are missing, and then the reach, your understanding, your choices, all these are basically working on some algorithms. And if you understand those algorithms correct, you can use social media marketing in a very efficient way. But if you don't, you can misguide your team and your marketing campaign. So that's why it is important to see what are the limitations on the social media also. So the social media is very efficient tools for today's market research. So now the second component was basically, let me just conclude this component. The second component was the role of marketing research in decision support system and management information. I explained to you it is very important part, and when you collect information internally you need researcher, and I gave you some examples. And if same time you want to collect information externally, you can use teams or internal researchers who can collect this information on your behalf. But remember, we can do this with the utilization of social media. So social media is very important tool nowadays in marketing research. So you can use big data analytics, and you can collect a lot of information through utilization of social media analytics or Google Analytics or maybe big data analytics. So this is how marketing research is very important and playing an important role in your organization nowadays. Let's see the third component. We do research, and in this case I explained to you all the research process and the importance of research. And we also know that the marketing research process is basically a strict six-step process. But remember, this six-step process, it takes a lot of stakeholders in it. It's not only one person who is doing the research, the researcher. There are different parts of this situation, this marketing research. Let us see what are the different parts. The first part is basically yourself, the researcher. The person who do the research is your, basically the main part, okay? The marketing researcher. So yourself and maybe myself, if I'm doing the research, or maybe if we assign this job to external partners, so they would be our marketing research. So the researcher is the first part. The second part is your client. This research If I am doing research, it is a service, obviously, then I have client, the organization which took my services in order to collect information or do market research. So they are my client. So the client is the second part, component or second stakeholder in your research. And the respondent, the people you are going to interview, or maybe you are going to collect data from them, they are basically your respondents. So respondents is the third element or third stakeholder in your research. And the public, the general public, the people around you, they are also stakeholders of your research. Okay, so there are four major categories of stakeholders in your research. Each stakeholder need to be dealt separately. They have their ethical understandings, or they have their ethical rights. So you cannot violate anyone's right there. If somebody who don't want to display his name, the respondent, you cannot collect information and tell his name to the all public. It is unethical. You cannot violate humans or human rights during this process. You cannot violate, or you cannot academic rule, we call it plagiarism, or other basic principles of your research process. Okay, so ethical considerations are very important. Your work should be based on your personal thinking or your own development. You cannot just copy and paste others' work and then you just do it in on your name. It is not possible. Your clients, they have rights. You will sign an agreement with them once you are in this research process. They need some outcomes from your research. It is your responsibility or your duty to provide them what is promised in your contract. So this you cannot violate, okay? But through any medium which is not ethical is not allowed in your research. At the same time, government policies are there. You have to consider them also. In the general public, for example, you cannot harm animals. Now this is very important. If you are doing clinical trials, you cannot harm animals or any human beings. Throughout the process, you have to avoid all those unethical practices, which is basically very important in doing research. So you have to understand the rights of these four parties, these four stakeholders, and everyone have their own rights. So you cannot violate these rules. And then especially the client side, you have to understand what are their rights and how they are going to how you are going to provide them what is being promised in the contract. So if anything you are not comfortable, you can write in the contract while we are doing this research, we are before starting. But once you sign that agreement, it means that you are in and you have to follow the rules and procedure. Then even in the different countries, they have different rules. You have to follow the government policies. You have to follow the organization policies. Maybe the data protection rights are there. The privacy policy are there. All these documents you should read before you start the process of research. Okay. For example, in your assignment, now here, this is my final part of my working today. I'm interested to see what are the ethical rights of the respondents in your assignment. So list down the rights of your customers, because we have collected information without their permission. If you consider this ethical, or we are going to take any approval from them, or maybe while we are writing an email to them, we will explain the process. You remember, if the information is already displayed openly on the website, it means that it is shareable and it is accessible to anyone. So that's why there is no ethical consideration on this. But once you send them email, that is the point where you may violate some of the ethical consideration or some of the rights of individuals. So at that time, you have to understand. So can you write this decision-making process, how research can help. So this is the class assignment, how research can help decision support system for the organization. And especially I want to see whether your research can help in any way to UTEM in case of their decision support system, whether they can make any decision if you give them this information, we have collected these email IDs and all this. And then what are the ethical consideration of your research process? So this is your class assignment. You have to write and upload on the portal. I will open this portal for you tomorrow so you can write it. Okay, now I think we are clear with the three components of today's learning outcome. Let us just conclude today's class. So I mainly focus on three main outcomes for today's class. The first one was basically your difference between management information system, marketing information system, and your decision support system. So management information system is the information within the organization. Marketing information is about the market internally or external to your organization, and decision support system is basically the system which allows us to make decision for the organizations. Okay, so these are three different differences between the MIS, marketing information system, and decision support system, the first component. The second component was basically to understand the role of marketing research in decision support system and management information system, which I explained. All the information required for this process is being collected with the research process, and research process, it allow you to make any decision, because at the end of your research you will give your policy recommendation to the organization, so it would be easier for them to play with the data and then make the decision based on your recommendation. And the final part I explained today is basically the ethical consideration during the research process. I explained there are four different types of stakeholders in your research, and each part you have six steps of research. Remember, each step have different ethical consideration. So when you are talking about the problem solving, looking at previous literature, trying to collect data, framework, all these six steps have different types of ethical consideration. You can read this on your book and also on the slides available to you. But remember, there are four major stakeholders of your research: researcher, the client, the respondent, and the general public. And then there may be more, like the organization, the government policies, the government maybe, but depends on the type of research you are doing. But mainly these four are the main stakeholders of your research, and each stakeholder have its own rights you cannot violate during your research process. So you have to be ethical and you have to follow the rules set by the organization and your contract. Okay, so these are the main ethical consideration, but you can read these in detail, and if anything is not clear, you can write down in the question box or in the comment box, so we can discuss it later on. But I hope you are very clear about these four different stakeholders and their ethical rights. Okay, so these are three major outcomes for today's lecture, and I hope you are very clear on it. And if you listen this and if you have any question, you can ask me and you can write down, or you can ask me in the next class. We can discuss this this before our starting our class. So you can just listen, just write down. But the class activity is very simple. You have to tell me about your research, how it can play any role for UTEM policy making or decision support system. Okay, do you think your work, what you are doing, is applicable for decision support system for UTEM? First thing. And the second thing, you have to tell me the ethical consideration during your research process, the collection of information, and when we are sending the information to our respondents. Okay, so do you have any thinking or any maybe 3, 4, or 5 different types of ethical consideration which you feel you must need to ensure before sending the email to the data we collected? Okay, so I hope you are very clear, and we can do this assignment. So let us conclude this session. I hope you understand the three major learning outcomes for today's lecture. And if you have any question, you can ask me. So I hope there is no question left. So see you in the next class. Hi, I'm Dr. IQ. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to learn about the market technology intelligence or marketing research methods. And for further notification, please don't forget to press bell icon. Thank you.